Hello students, now we shall look at a storage reservoir based hydro power plant. So basically storage reservoir means that when there is a dam built, then whatever behind that water is stored, that becomes a huge reservoir. Okay, so most of the dams what we have in India, when they are built, there is a storage created, the reservoir. So these are built against across some rivers, like we are discussing about Kali River. Okay, you can see in this picture there is a river flowing. Okay, then there is a dam built, and because of the dam you have got a huge reservoir now. And the exit of the dam, in the dam you have got the powerhouse, and the exit is a river. So this is known as storage reservoir based hydel power plants, very popular. Now there is something called pondaged reservoir based hydel power. Pondage means like rivers are very big, ponds are small. So a small pond is built. So you can see here there is a weir is there, river is flowing, and backside there is a small pond is created, 4x4 pondage and the powerhouse. So here what happens for smaller capacity power plants, so we don't require this big amount of water, so we'll have a small pondage, okay, and diversion, and there will be a small pondage here, and in that there is a powerhouse which generates the power, and the tail race of the outlet of the powerhouse, the tail race will go and again connect to the main river itself. Okay, this is known as pondage reservoir based hydel power plant. But in India what we have seen mostly storage reservoir based hydel power plants. This pondage reservoir based hydel power plants will be very small. So this low head, medium head, high head we have seen. And now we will see the general layout of a hydel power plant. In the general layout of the hydel power plant, you can see again there is a reservoir, the dam is built, and because of the dam there is a reservoir, and you can see the thick this is a gate, so that this gate controls the flow of water from the reservoir to the penstock. Okay, there is a gate. Okay, and from the there is a 4-bay here, again there is a small dam here, and then there is a penstock, again penstock, and because it is high head, they are provided one more surge tanks, and this anchor blocks are to support this penstock, big pipe as I said. So there is a powerhouse, and the tail race is there, and the outlet of the powerhouse comes in the form of a tail race. In the draft tube, and this draft tube meets the tail race. Please understand, especially this reaction turbines like Kaplan turbine and Francis turbine, their draft tube should always be in the water only, then only the water will flow. Okay, because the pressures are very much reduced there. Okay, that is why the draft tube, you can see the design is there, the conical in nature basically, where the volume goes on increasing towards the tail race end. So this is a layout of a general layout of a diesel power sorry hydel power plant, and these are the protective devices what I have seen, like surge tank and all, they are the protective devices used there. And types of dam also, now super dam you have seen, that was a gravity dam built like this. Then you have got arched dam, you have also got buttress dam, then you have got something called earthen dam, where the only the central core is RCC wall, and it is made of earth, and then stone lining is given, pitching is given at the end, okay, surface. And please see all these dams now, you can see top the level thickness will be less, but as you go down, because the water pressure increases, the area becomes large to withstand the water pressure. Similar last field is a rock filled dam, you can see dry rubble masonry and stone pitching is done. Okay, and there are spillways also, the extra water has to be lent out because it will damage, so there are spillways are provided. You can see what are the types of spillways. One Oogie spillway, so very simple it is, when the overflow is there, it will overflow from the top. This is a Oogie spillway. Then this is chute spillway. Here also you can see the from the top only they are provided a slope so that water can run off. Okay, and then is a shaft spillway. This shaft, this is like this dots with the small triangles. This is all concrete. This represents concrete, and this dash hatching represents water. So here you can see the shaft, vertical shaft. There is a shaft provided, and bottom there is a concrete tunnel. So any excess water when it comes to this level, it will go flow into the vertical shaft, and from the vertical shaft, because of the concrete tunnel, it will pass away. This is a shaft spillway, and lastly you can see the siphon spillway. Siphon spillway is simple. Again here you can see the this is a concrete block they have made. In this they have made like passage, so that you can see when the water comes up to the A level, it will flow through this passage, and it will ultimately go out to the from the this right side end to the B end. This is known as siphon spillway. Okay. And again, what we discussed about the surge tank, you can see there is a dam, the reservoir, and a surge tank. This A, B, C, there are three levels are given here. So A level means normal, take a normal flow, normal demand. But if the suddenly the demand increases, then what happens? C, then the water level will flow, come down. It will come to C. This is high flow, sudden rise in demand. Okay, but if the demand is reduced suddenly, then instead of A, it will go up to B, that is reduced flow and reduced demand. So this way, based on the demand, the level of water in the surge tank will vary. It has got a normal level of A. If more water required, the level will fall down to B, so come down to C. And if reduced water requirement is there, then it will go back to B. So this is a protective device of the surge tank. And we will see the surge tanks also. Different types of surge tanks are given. Left one, that is top, cylindrical. Then these are like geometry shapes only, conical. Then there is a spillway type also. The overflow will spill out from the surge tank also. Okay. Then there is a differential surge tank, works on differential water levels. And then gallery type surge tank and inclined surge tanks are also there. Okay. So then draft tube, as I was telling, the draft tube that connects the turbine outlet to the tail race. And you can see this draft tube, you can see in our college, we have got that all the three turbines, Francis turbine, Kaplan turbine and Pelton wheel. There you can see the draft tube. Okay, straight divergent, then Moody spreading, then simple elbow, and lastly straight divergent. Okay, these are the types of draft tube. Okay, so in the last class, next class, we will see the turbine governing. Thank you.